This is CNN Breaking News.
Welcome to our viewers in the United States and around the world. This is New Day. It's Wednesday, September 6th, 6 o'clock here in New York. We got a big morning for you. Hurricane Irma is a monster Category 5 storm slamming parts of the Caribbean, packing 185-mile-an-hour winds. This is the most powerful storm ever recorded in the Atlantic Ocean. It just went over the island of Barbuda hours ago. Irma's impact expected to be catastrophic. You have the storm surge, the winds, and flash flooding. At this point, Puerto Rico, the Dominican Republic, Haiti, Cuba, all in the direct line of fire, as you see on your screen. The big question mark, Florida.
So Florida is under a state of emergency even now as Irma approaches. People are emptying out store shelves. They're dealing, as you can see, with long lines at gas stations. We are also this morning following two other big stories for you. That's the fallout from President Trump's decision to end the program that protects dreamers from deportations. And in a few hours, President Trump has a critical phone call with China's president over the North Korea threat. CNN has the global coverage of this like none other. So we begin with Hurricane Irma and CNN's Leila Santiago. She is live for us in Puerto Rico. What's the situation there, Leila?
Allison, we're certainly feeling the winds pick up, the water, the waves come in a little more aggressively here in Isla Verde in Puerto Rico. You know, Irma right now at this hour, 225 miles southeast of where we are. And yet, as we drove around this morning, I could already tell that people are getting ready. I mean, people went to sleep last night not knowing what we would wake up to today. I have been in touch with the governor's office. They tell me they are wrapping up a meeting right now to get the latest with all the emergency management officials who've been working overnight. There are shelters in place, 460 of them, many of them already opening up, ready to take people, especially from the eastern part of the island, where these are really flood-prone areas. And, you know, this is, and you can see the water coming up behind me. You know, Puerto Rico is a Caribbean island. We are used to seeing tropical storms and hurricanes this time of year. It's hurricane season, but you know, this is something the governor has said that is expected to be catastrophic. It's expected to be of a magnitude they have never experienced here on this island. But the mood right now is a let's wait and see, hope for the best, but really we don't think things are going to end up well here.
All right, Leila, thank you very much. Be safe. Joining us by the phone now is the governor, Ricardo Rossello. Governor, can you hear me?
Yes, thank you so much.
Well, thank you for making the time. We know you just got out of a meeting for the emergency planning. Do you believe you are where you need to be in terms of preparation?
Yes, we've been preparing for this for about a week already, on top of having initial preparations with all our team for the past 5 months. You know, Puerto Rico seems to be always in the line of fire with hurricanes flowing through. You know, we've always wanted to make sure we prepare. Critically, we looked at the areas of flooding so that we could mobilize people. We also are focused on a last 24 hours mobilization effort. So we are hoping for the best, but of course preparing for the worst. This is a Category 5 hurricane, unlike it's never been seen before. So although we hope the trajectory continues up northward, we are preparing for the worst. And, of course, keeping people safe is our main objective.
Most people are sheltering in place, of course, but do you have people in the shelters already?
Yes, we do have people. We have a real-time feedback mechanism so that we can see how many people are safe. We are working with the most vulnerable populations. Our team worked the past week to identify those potentially critical flooding areas so that we can start moving people and get them on the mindset that this could be a very tough storm. So things are moving. Of course, once again, I reiterate, we will feel strong, very strong winds. And we expect and we hope that it sort of skids northwards. But we are preparing for the worst, a Category 5 hurricane. And our main objective right now is not infrastructure, but it's the safety of the people of Puerto Rico.
What's your biggest concern in terms of the possibilities? We know that there's a little bit of chance in the path of the storm and which part of the storm actually hits the island.
Well, there's two main areas of concern. Obviously, under any hurricane, any category, flooding is a main concern. We just saw in Harvey how the main cause of death was essentially flooding. So we really tackled that early on with preventative measures. Mm-hmm. But the second area of concern, of course, is Category 5 winds are really aggressive. Just to give our viewers a perspective, it's essentially the speed of a Boeing 340 airplane taking off. So these are very strong winds that we're talking about, something that we have never experienced here in Puerto Rico, and quite frankly, and not a lot of jurisdictions have. So again, we ask the people to keep us in their thoughts and prayers, hoping for the worst part of the hurricane to get us by, but essentially, we know we're going to feel strong hurricane winds anyway, and what we want to make sure is that we have our people safe and that we can rebuild immediately afterwards.
All right, and please know that you can reach out to us with any information that people need to hear, and I hope that everybody is wrong and that somehow this storm does less than is expected. Governor, be safe and be well.
Thank you so much for the opportunity.
All right, Allison.
Okay, Chris, there are also mandatory evacuations and school closings in the Florida Keys today in advance of Irma. People from Miami Beach to Jacksonville are loading up on food and supplies. They are leaving store shelves empty. CNN's Rosa Flores is live in Miami with more. What's the situation there, Rosa?
Allison, good morning. Well, this storm is moving in with the fury, but Florida is preparing with the fury as well. Mandatory evacuations have already been issued for Monroe County. That includes Key West. Now, here in Miami-Dade, people with disabilities will be evacuating starting today, with possible evacuation orders in this county for portions of this county, possible today or tomorrow. Now, people are responding to the call to heed the warning for this monster storm. Public officials asking people to have food and supplies for at least 3 days. And indeed, we're seeing empty shelves in grocery stores and hardware stores and long lines at gas stations. Our friends to the north in Broward County have 43 shelters that can shelter about 33,000 people. And statewide, the governor of this state has issued a disaster declaration for all 67 counties and tapped into all 7,000 National Guard members and all of their assets and resource capabilities. Allison.
All right, Rosa, thank you very much. You saw those lines of the traffic there. For a lot of people, the calculation becomes, is it worth the time to evacuate? And that is a choice that often comes with big consequences. Later on, we're going to talk about the situation in Florida, what they're worried about, what they're ready for with Governor Rick Scott. All right, we want to show you some really incredible footage of Hurricane Irma from space. One of the reasons that at least the meteorologists are marveling at what they're calling almost a perfect storm in terms of its formation, its shape, churning in that eye captured by the International Space Station. Here's the actual eye. Take a look at that. That is your energy source, and obviously all the pain spreads outward from there. Now, as beautiful as it is, who cares? What we want is it for the mist, all the vital and populated areas. Then it all comes down to the path. Let's get right to CNN meteorologist Chad Myers. We get that it's a pretty storm. We get that it's a huge storm. The question is, where is it going to go? What's it going to do?
Well, over the next 24 to 48 hours, I think we really know that. After 72, you still have about 150 miles either way that the storm can go. Right now, Barbuda really took a direct hit. At 185 miles per hour, there may not be vegetation left on the island. Now St. Martin up toward Anguilla and eventually the BVI later on this morning, and really right over just to the north of Puerto Rico. That'll be a battering wind and battering waves for Puerto Rico, and then eventually on up into the Bahamas, really causing significant damage to the Bahamas. Some of the islands aren't more than 9 feet tall. Storm surge here maybe 20 feet. You get the idea what's going to happen to those islands. So what has changed overnight? A significant change from here to here. But all the models this morning are here. But the Weather Service said, National Hurricane Center said, wait a minute, let's not go over here just yet. Let's kind of average it out because we believe that yesterday this was pretty good. Now today we'll have to see if this new path, this new model run is correct, and we'll know that later on this morning. Here are the models from overnight. Notice the big hard right-hand turn could scour Miami Beach all the way up even into North Carolina. It could go even to the right of there. We're watching the Bahamas very closely, but clearly if Miami-Dade up to Card Sound Road and Homestead pick up the eye of this storm, it's a devastating storm for South Florida. That's the center of the eye. Don't focus on it yet. 150 miles left or right. There are the models. They're saying landfall in Charleston. A couple days away. Make sure you pay attention. Not yet time to evacuate because we don't know where to go just yet. Guys?
Got it. Okay. Keep following those models for us, Chad. Thank you very much. Now,